Good morning, all of you. This is your 11th science biology class. And we have to take chapter 2.2. Chapter 2.2 Padugi. You know, fungi is the another kingdom of five kingdom classification system. We have discussed in our earlier classes the five kingdom classification. First one is Monera and second one is Protista. Now we have discussed the third kingdom is fungi. You know, the word fungi is the plural form and its singular form is fungus. Fungus means simply, agar hum kahein, to fungus means hota hai cocoon. It is a layer which arises on chapatis or bread. When they spoil, then some layer of fungus are deposited on it. The pickles, if the pickles are wetted, then a layer of whitish color deposit on the pickles. This is known as fungus. So fungus is a singular form and fungi is a plural form of the kingdom fungi. Now, about 1 lakh known species are around our surrounding of fungus. So there are 1 lakh species known. From a Latin word mushroom, the word comes from the Latin word mushroom. It means fungus. So fungus derived from a Latin word, its meaning is mushroom. The scientist Whittaker gave us 5 classification system, and the study of fungus is known as mycology. So the branch of science or biology in which we have studied about the fungus is known as mycology. Now the father of modern mycology is Antoine de Berry is the father of modern mycology. The fungi are living and dynamic structure. So fungi are the living and dynamic structure. Now we have discussed characteristics features of fungi. The characteristic feature of fungi, first feature is fungi are achlorophyllous. Achlorophyllous, it means that they does not have chlorophyll and they do not prepare their own food. So fungi are achlorophyllous. Next thing is the body structure is just like a hyphae. So its body structure just like a thin structure is known as hyphae. So hyphae is the singular form hypha. The network of hyphae is called mycelium. Many hyphae are linked together to form a mycelium. So mycelium is the network of hyphae. Many hyphae linked together to form a network structure is known as mycelium. Hyphae may be septate or aseptate. Septate means these hyphae are divided into many parts. So septa divide hyphae into its many parts. So septa are present and it is not present. So the hyphae may be septated or aseptated. Next one, its cell wall made up of chitin. So the cell wall of fungus, this one is the cell wall, and it is made up of chitin. So the structure of fungus is composed of many hyphae combined together to form mycelium. The hyphae contain septa or septate, and it does not have septa or aseptate. So the cell wall of the mycelium or hyphae is made up of chitin. This is the characteristic feature of fungi. Now next one is, cell wall is made up of chitin in fungal cellulose, and some one the made up of cellulose. The reserve or stored food material is glycogen or oil droplet. Is storing food material is glycogen or in the form of small oil droplets. Then next one is reproduction. Reproduction in fungi are sexual as well as asexual. So both type of reproduction, sexual and asexual, are take place in fungi. Now next characteristic feature, vascular tissue are completely absent in fungi. There are no vascular tissue present in fungi. These cells are eukaryotic in nature. The cells of fungi are eukaryotic in nature. It means they have well-developed nucleus and cell organelle bounded by the membrane. So eukaryotic cell present in fungus. Example are mucor, rhizopus, aspergillus, yeast, penicillin, and Puccinia are the example of some fungi. Habitat, they are grow on organic matter, living or dead. So its habitat is organic matter, living or dead organic matter, where it is found. Most of them are terrestrial fungi. So humus soil, the humus of soil is made up of fungi. This is the habitat of fungi. Now some aquatic fungi are considered to be primitive. They are found in water or moisture, such as bread, jam, pickles, fruits and vegetables. So these fungus arose on these food materials. And fungi preferred to grow damp and dark and humid place. We can earlier observe that fungus are developed on humid or moisture places or dark places. Now we have discussed the structure of its thallus, fungi, structure of thallus. So let's see the structure of hyphae. Its cell wall is made up of chitin, and it has nucleus. This one is nucleus. And some vacuoles are also there, these large vacuoles, which is the storing material, vacuoles, and these are the septa, So, it is the structure of the fungus. Now, our next topic of fungus is the nutrition in fungi. So our next topic is nutrition in fungi. heterotrophic mode of nutrition and symbiotic nutrition. So nutrition in fungi may be classified nutrition in fungi may be classified into two groups, autotrophic and symbiotic. Autotrophic mode of nutrition and symbiotic type of mode of nutrition. Now, heterotrophic. Heterotrophic type of mode of nutrition may be classified into pericyte and saprophyte. It is pericyte and first one is pericyte and second one is saprophyte. Now, pericyte type of mode of nutrition is obligate and facultative. These are further classified obligative and second one is facultative. Obligative and facultative, and these are also divided obligative and facultative. Now, this is the classification of mode of nutrition. So, on the base of mode of nutrition, fungi are of two types. First one is heterotrophic. Why? Because they does not contain chlorophyll. So in fungi, autotrophic mode of nutrition is absent. It is heterotrophic type of mode of nutrition and symbiotic. Heterotrophic means they depend upon food for the other organism. And symbiotic. Symbiotic means if both species are beneficial to each other, then such type of mode of nutrition is known as symbiotic type of mode of nutrition. Now, parasites are those organisms which depend on their food for the other organism upon the other organism, such as obligative and facultative, means complete parasite and semi-parasite. So, saprophyte are both organisms which depends upon their food on the dead and decayed organic material. So, such type of mode of nutrition is known as saprophyte. So, this is the mode of nutrition in fungi. Now, our next topic of this chapter is reproduction in fungi. So there are three types of mode of nutrition, mode of reproduction: vegetative, asexual and sexual. We can discuss these three mode of reproduction one by one. So first one is vegetative mode of reproduction. So mode of reproduction takes place in fungi. Reproduction reproduction in fungi. It may be classified into three groups: vegetative mode of nutrition, asexual mode of reproduction, and third one is sexual. So there are three types of mode of reproduction take place in fungi. First one is vegetative. It may cause by the five types. So vegetative may be five types. First one is budding. Budding. Second one is fissure. Fissure. Third one is fragmentation. Fragmentation. Next one is oidia. And chylomicrosis. This one is chylomicrosis. So this is the point of vegetative reproduction. Now we have discussed the asexual. It may be caused by five things or five mold. First one is polygia. Second one is blue spores. Third one is tabletum spore. Eclinum spore. Fourth one is sporangium spore. And fifth one is binucleate spore. So these five are the mode of asexual reproduction. Now sexual reproduction takes place by phylogenetic. First one is phylogenetic. Second one is gametogenital. Third one is gametogenital population. And next one is spermatization. And last one is somatogamy. So these are the mode of reproduction in fungi. First of all, vegetative reproduction is budding. Budding means bud is the sum of growth which form from the outer surface of the body, and after disconnect the body, it produces new organ. Such type of vegetative reproduction is known as budding. Fissure, it means its body separated into two parts and each part develops into the new organism. Fragmentation means the body divided into many fragments, many parts, and each part becomes into new organism. So such type of vegetative reproduction is known as fragmentation. Oidia is a cell which can form, is known as the divide into many small thin walled structure, is known as oidia. Means its hyphae divide some small bile-like structure which is known as oidia, and it develops into the new organism. It is unicellular in function. Next one is chlamydospores. Chlamydospores is the spherical spores are known as chlamydospores. So these type of mode of vegetative reproduction in fungi, first one is budding, second one is fission, third one is fragmentation, next one is oidia, which is the small bodies, say unicellular, and chlamydospore, it is the spherical spore-like structure. Now we have to take asexual reproduction. First one is conidia. It means that they are non-motile, exogenous, unicellular spores which are formed by the special type of fungal branch called conidiophore. So on conidiophore, some spore-like structure are formed, are known as conidia. These conidia are dispersed by water, wind, and under favorable condition, it gives rise to the birth of new organism. Next one is zoospore. Zoospore is the motile lower fungal. They have zoospores. They are uniflagellate or biflagellate. Means in the presence of flagella, they move from one place to another. So they are motive, and on germinating, they give the new fungal hyphae. Next one is aplanospore. Aplanospore are non-flagellate. These are non-motile. So aplanospore give birth to the special type of fungal. Next one is sporangiospore. Sporangiospore produce on sporangia and usually dispersed by wind. So they disperse by wind and produce new hyphae. Next one is binucleate. Binucleate is the form of rust fungi. Example, Puccinia, it has binucleated cell. So it is the binucleated spore. They have two nucleus on it. Now, these are the type of some asexual mode of reproduction. Now, we have discussed the sexual mode of reproduction. First one is planogamete. Planogamy means the gametes of opposite sex come close to each other, and after fusion, they form two gametes, take place, and result of which two haploid nuclei come closer to each other. This type of mode of reproduction is known as plasmogamy. Now, karyogamy. In karyogamy, haploid nuclei join together, link together to form a diploid cell is known as zygote, and this zygote further develop into the new hyphae. So this type of sexual reproduction is known as karyogamy. Now next one is then gametangial contact. In this method, two gametes, male gametes as well as female gamete, fuse together, and fusion of these gametes is known as fertilization. And after fertilization, the new contain anthridium into oogonium, and this migration of the transfers of genetic material. So this is known as gametangial contact. Now third one is gametangial copulation. In this type of reproduction, the entire contact of two gametangia take place by dissolution of their contact wall, and resulting in the formation of single cell. known as zoospores. This type of reproduction is known as mucor and rhizopus. It means that the wall of two gametes are dissolved and the genetic material are transferred and zoospores are formed, and these zoospores reproduce new organisms. So such type of reproduction is known as gametangian population. Next one, fourth one is spermatization. This one. So spermatization means many fungi have non-motile single cell structure which is called spermatia. These spermatia are transferred through a genesis like wind, water and insect and respective hyphae. Then this type of fusion is known as spermatization. This takes place in Puccinia. And last one is somatogamy. The somatogamy, formation of gametes is absent in somatogamy, and nuclei of bulk passes of corresponding somatic cell by dissolving the wall. So there are no gamete found in somatogamy and it takes place in the somatic cell. There are no genital cells required for this type of sexual reproduction. So these five types are the mode of sexual reproduction in algae and in fungi. Now our next topic of this chapter is the classification of fungi and difference between algae and fungi. So mode of reproduction in fungi is over here, complete here. So our next topic is the difference between algae and fungi. Now we take the difference between algae and fungi. What is the difference between algae and fungi? First one, algae is grow in aquatic and semi-aquatic habitat. Algae always found in aquatic and semi-aquatic, means water or less water. And fungi, they are grow in rich organic matter. They are grow on the rich organic matter. Second one, algae possess chlorophyll, but fungi does not possess chlorophyll. Third one is, they are photoautotrophic. They have photoautotrophic type of mode of nutrition. So in algae, mode of nutrition is photoautotrophic. It means that they prepare their own food with the help of light. But in fungi, there is no chlorophyll present. So the mode of nutrition is heterotrophic. Next one is, algae grow in well lighted areas. Algae always grow lighted areas, matlab they have light, but fungi does not grow on the lighted areas. They have grow always in the dark places or marshy places. Cell wall of algae is made up of cellulose, but cell wall of fungi is made up of cellulose and chitin. Reserve food material is starch, whereas reserve food material is glycogen. Now, motile spores and motile gametes are present in the algae, but only zoospores are motile gametes. They may be in rare form. Sexual reproduction is plasmogamy and karyogamy. Here, delayed after the completion of plasmogamy. So these are the major difference of algal cell and fungi. So this is the difference of algae and fungi. So our this lecture is over here. Kingdom fungi. Now our next lecture, we have discussed the classification of fungi. Then till then, goodbye, thank you, and take care of you. Okay.